Hello and welcome to another video for LinMob.net. Now, as you can see, this is yet another distribution overview, and this time it's OpenSUSE Tumbleweed. It's SLAM OS, which stands for SUSE Linux Mobile Enhanced. No, Enhanced Mobile, that's what it was. Operating system, so SUSE Linux Enhanced Mobile Operating System, obviously based on OpenSUSE Tumbleweed here. And I didn't have a look at it before, but I was recently asked about it in a YouTube comment. And by the way, I like these distributions that don't hide what's happening while they're booting up. So that's one thing to write. And there we are. This is a different font. Looks very different, this Forge lock screen. Now the passcode is 1234. And okay, so we are back in October. It's October 13th, and there's not much pre-installed here. I saw scrolling through earlier that the camera wasn't found properly, so I doubt that this one, which looks like it's pinhole, is actually going to work at all. So let's just briefly try it anyway. And yeah, that's not really working. Also, it scales weird, and that's because this one is per default in dock mode, which is very strange. That doesn't happen to me with Arch Linux ARM, and so you have to put it in undocked to make these apps scale properly. For example, with this GNOME software. Okay, it doesn't work that way around, but now it's in docked, and I would start that, and it's still fine. Well, yeah. So that's the demo effect here, but yeah, as you can see, that's different, and I think it's interesting that you can do that manually wherever you are. And it looks like an oversight, but I think they just didn't catch up to the latest Forge upgrades here fully. Now, I'm noticing that I actually seem to... I think I forgot to turn on my special Wi-Fi router for this, which I'm always using for my videos, so I'll be back in a minute. See you soon. So here I am, and I hope that my router is now booting up, or access point, my LinMob access point, but I don't see it yet. So maybe let's just disable Wi-Fi, enable it again. No. Doesn't show yet. There it is. So let me enter the stupid simple password that you all already know and connect. And here we go. Internet. Yeah. So that's great. Now, there aren't many apps, and there's the phone app, but apparently the modem doesn't work in this current image. I know that it did work earlier, but that's on a previous image, and I'm just testing this one because, yeah, and I'm sure they are going to fix it so that it works again sooner than later. So Shatty will be mostly useless too. But let's just see here whether we can add accounts. Okay. Now that is kind of weird. I don't really see... Oh yeah, that shows, but then it's kind of off and it's... yeah, whatever. So it only supports XMPP here. It supports XMPP by default, but on Arch Linux ARM at least, I think it also supports Telegram and Matrix, because this is LibPurple based and there are tons of backends for LibPurple, and I really hope to see more of them properly integrated into Shetty soon. So that we could even have stuff like Signal or maybe even Threema and so on, many other messengers in this app, and it would be great if that would happen. But then again, some of these backends aren't really all that stable, so depends whether it's worth the effort. So somebody has to do it, and it's a ton of work, and I let's not pressure anyone here, you know. Sure, that's all work that's mostly done by free people in their free time, and they deserve credit for this. By the way, I really like this wallpaper, and this is, what did I start there? Oh, that's Epiphany, the web browser, so that should just work. But I would guess that it doesn't have the scaling patches yet, and I forgot to type HTTPS here. So let me. Oh, I can't choose the terminal keyboard. Oh, that's weird. So I have to somehow find the right point here. So up. And now it hopefully can load my blog. Yay! And I will need to look into the automatic redirection, because normally it should work, and I think it usually does. Don't know why it doesn't work here, but it's interesting catch. So yeah, of course I don't have OpenSUSE column in Linmob apps yet, and I don't know whether I'm going to add one or that, whether that's going to be something for the future app directory when that's happening. So contacts again is going to be pretty bare and boring, because I don't have any here. It's just local address book and then done, and it's the same app everywhere, and you can just then add a contact, and maybe it's working or maybe it isn't. Here, see, you can enter a ton of data, even more. So I think this contacts app everywhere is, it gets the job done, you know. It may not be the best, most full-featured of every content app, contact app in the world, but it's fine. So the camera, we saw on booting up that it doesn't work, and here's nice desk screen, and that's still pinhole. It's not megapixels, so even if it was working, it wouldn't be very good, most likely. Then flashlight works from the Fosh menu, and the flashlight app also works, but it's kind of pointless now. Nemo is installed as a file manager. Yeah, no surprises there. Let's close it and then look into usage. Okay, pretty normal so far. RAM use is not that super low, but it's fine, I think. They don't have a swap by default, which is, well, standard. Manjaro comes with the default swap, which is, I think, one of their better ideas. And then, yeah, installed, works, updates, are there any updates? Did it check? No, so I'm not sure whether this works at all, so I could search. I think some of the Plasma Mobile packages are actually packaged up for OpenSUSE, weirdly enough, but not in here. Oh no, nothing shows up. So then we've got the settings app. Yeah, no surprise here. It doesn't show the mobile networking thing, but apparently the modem just doesn't work with this build, wherever that is. And I don't see anything of the usual here. It looks pretty normal. It has the displays panel, which is, should be nice for convergence, but I'm not going to test that here, because look, the modem isn't working. Where's the point in testing additional features? That's King's Cross, and now Fosh crashed, and I hope it's going to be back soon. King's Cross, by the way, that's not just the London terminus of the Northeastern line or something, or whatever it is, you know, railway station. Oh, sorry. Adverse habits. It's the terminal KGX, and Again, we are in dock mode and we need to enter undock mode to have it scale properly, because otherwise we could, I mean, we could do fun stuff. We could do move the window around, maybe. No, we can't really do that. That's unfortunate. Yeah. Now, I really haven't used OpenSUSE in a while, generally, so I'm not too sure how those, what that zipper syntax was again. I think it is zipper up to update, and then yeah. Trust always. Yeah, now it's retrieving the repository, and I'll just go ahead and jump to conclusions. This is certainly interesting. It's OpenSUSE and it doesn't come with Yast, which is the part of OpenSUSE that I really always dreaded a bit, because it's so different. And yeah, but I know that if you're used to OpenSUSE, you're going to love that thing. So yeah, but it doesn't ship on the PinePhone yet, apparently. And it says that it has 4 updates, but the update are not going to be installed. I don't know what to do with that. I think I'm going to revisit this at a later date. I'm not sure what to think of this font. I think it looks nerdy, but yeah, whatever. And yeah, there are a couple things that need to be done. I wouldn't recommend you to use this currently unless you're a hardcore OpenSUSE fan and you just really need to see this nice wallpaper here, nice gecko. So yeah, but at least it boots, and we had some fun with it, so let's not be mean, and see you soon in another video. Have fun and goodbye.